In the previous tutorial, we taught our robot to spin around like this, but we want to make it stop and to press forward and push the toy out of the ring. To remind you, what our program does is we start here at this green triangle. It goes into the first part of the loop. It goes into the motor command, which turns one motor with a power of 30% and the other motor with a power of minus 30%. One forwards 30%, one backwards 30%. A fraction of a second later, it comes to this loop. This goes, says, oh, we don't finish, we go back to the beginning. Keep the motor going. Okay, so it keeps going like that. How long does it keep it going for? It keeps it going for unlimited, forever. That 8 on its side is an infinity sign, forever. Now, the way we get Yayabot to stop spinning is to change this command. We'll click here. We have an ultrasonic sensor, and we have distance inches, distance in centimeters. Because I'm ancient, I was brought up in inches, and I'll choose that. And we're choosing 4, which is less than. In other words, this will stop if it's less than a certain amount. I'll put in 30 inches, which is about the length of my Sumo arena. And so this will mean that what happens now is it'll come in to the loop, it will start the motor going, and it will then check if there's anything which is less than 30 inches or 75 centimeters away. If there isn't, it'll keep going, it'll keep turning. Is there anything less than 30 inches, 75 centimeters? Nope, keep going until finally it sees something. And if it sees something which is less than 30 inches or 75 centimeters, then it hops out of the loop and it does whatever is after this. We don't have anything after this, so let's put something in. We'll get rid of the documentation window by closing the content editor by clicking up here, and we can use the move tank command after this. Since this will theoretically, at least if everything's gone right, be pointing in the direction of our toy, when it sees something less than 30 inches, 75 centimeters, it will go straight towards the toy. At the moment, it will go one rotation at speed 50. Speed 50 is okay, but we'll need more than one rotation because that's a very short distance. In the case of my particular Sumo arena, I'll probably put in, say, 9 rotations. And we'll try and see if that works. Before we download for the first time, we just check a couple of things. Motors are B and C, that's okay, that's where they are in Yayabot. Our ultrasonic sensor is in port 3, good, that's where it is. If we wanted to correct that, we've got that. We click in 3 and that's where it will be. And we looks okay, so we'll download it to Yayabot. Turning. Oh, excellent. Pushes it straight out. Good work.